Get your question, bro.
But no, my question is, ladies, Dan, when you look at a guy, what is it about him that makes you be like, friend zone? I'm gonna put him in a friend zone. Like, what does the guy do or say, or what is, or does he look like a certain way that makes you be like, okay, you know what?
Trying
I'm gonna
too
put
hard.
Him in his friend zone instead of
maybe trying
the other
too
guy.
Hard.
Cockiness.
Okay, let's go one at a time. Who wants to go first?
Okay,
you can go first.
Oh, trying too hard. Okay. Just corny.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Okay, so the question is, what is it? Your question was, what is it that a guy does that puts the guy in a friend zone?
Yes.
If he's trying too hard and if he's corny. Now elaborate. What is something that? Yeah, what does a man have to do where it's like, oh, he's trying too hard? What is that?
Like saying stuff that, you know, like being super boastful and stuff, like really trying to bag you by what he got. Like, oh, I got this, and oh, I'm known by this, and such know me and this. Like, shut up.
Okay.
Like, who cares?
And then you also say corny. What would make a man corny?
That too.
Okay. She's like, yeah, up. If he's doing that, then that nigga corny too.
Yeah, you trying to? Are you trying to? I just say no interview as far as a job. Like, I don't need your resume. Like, just show me. I don't need you to list
in
off.
In a way, you know, kind of do need a resume though.
But I don't need you to list off your traits. I need you to, you know, show
the traits.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't need you to list
enough.
It off like you in the interview.
So, a dude that's trying too hard and corny. And what about you? What makes you put a dude in the friend zone?
It's kind of similar to that too.
Well, what are they doing? Like, what are they doing or saying that makes you be like, you know, nope, friend zone.
Yeah, like, come up with like an actual example. Like, y'all get DMs, right, ladies? Y'all
that's
have
soon
the guys
as you drop
DMs?
That dick pic inside my shit is like,
okay.
No.
Okay.
I don't even
guys.
Care how big it is. I don't care none of that. It's like, yeah. All the time. I get a merry day, literally.
You get the shaboinks in there? You get the shaboink away?
I go around my job showing my coworkers, like, yo, look. So don't drop in my DMs because I'm showing everybody I work with.
I ain't even showing nobody.
They don't even come my DMs trying to miss.
It's just blocked.
Oh. Okay.
What is something that they said that made you want to put them in a friend zone?
And actually, let's speak.
And not even in a
I got you. Let me help you out. Think about something specifically. My point is that y'all get guys that approach y'all, and y'all also get guys that hit on y'all in y'all DMs, like social media wise. Now, you have put dudes in friend zone, meaning like, something about him made you put him in a friend zone, right? Either if it was a DM or when he approached you. We want that, like the specifics.
I don't put nobody in a friend zone that immediately.
We know what you. You already said.
I don't even put a guy in a friend zone, but automatically, if you're like not my type, I'm just already putting you in the friend zone automatically in my brain. Like if you're not my type, I'm not even going there with you.
Mm. Okay, and so if he's not your type,
yeah.
Have you
so you
ever,
have to be black.
A question.
And you can't like somebody recently stepped up to me and was like, "Are you married?" And I'm like, "No." And they were Spanish, and he said, "Why don't you like want to be with me?" And I'm like, "Cause you're Spanish. I don't deal with Spanish
Damn,
guys."
You racist between your own race. God dang.
She okay. likes what she likes.
I like
she
what like, I like.
She
likes
so what she likes. That's your preference.
I'm not just going to go.
Fair enough. So here's a question. You said that if the dude isn't your type, he goes into the friend zone. Now here's a question. What if the dude is your type? What would put him in a friend zone? Because I'm sure you met some guys that's your type physically, but maybe he did something, said something, or something about him made you was like, friend zone.
Friend zone.
Could it be just a friend zone or just not talking to them? Period.
If you're not giving up, he's in friend zone.
Well, recently somebody tried to take me out to a hotel and they told me to pay for the hotel.
But he was your type.
He was my type. He had a
physically.
face card. He was my type.
Okay, physically he was your type.
Yes.
But the fact that he didn't pay for things, like he seen that he had a lack of financial ability, that disqualified him and put him in a friend zone.
So it wasn't about the financial ability, because
well,
I can
that is
like
true.
No, it's really not.
You said that
because at first, when I first met him, I was paying for stuff. Like I he had to give me gas. He didn't give me gas money. I'm really nice with money because I have
it. Time out. Did he hit?
No.
Okay, so he never hit. And
no.
So y'all was hanging out and. You'll be driving and he wouldn't give you gas money.
No.
So then it came to a situation where like pretty much I was about to smash because he was like, yo, y'all talked about getting a telly. And then he was like 50-50 or you had to pay for it
No,
all?
He's like, put your name and your card. And I'm like, no, I'm good. And I'm not going nowhere.
Gotcha. So look,
if you're taking
so,
me out.
Got you. So if he would have paid for it, like, listen, baby, we got the Holiday Inn, everything.
Yeah, if you would have been there.
Well, listen.
Yeah.
I got the jacuzzi. We got the Holiday Inn. You sliding through? Would you have slid with
yes,
him?
Yes, I would have.
So here's what I'm saying. The fact is that you disqualified him due to his lack of financial ability. His lack of being able to pay for the date.
No, because he tried to get me, talking about testing me, and see if I can pay for stuff as a female. No, you just jumping?
You missed it. It went right past your head. Yeah. You missed it. Yeah. It flew right
you
by you.
You just said he wanted you to pay for it, so you said no. But you just said yes to Cooley if you
oh, if he was paying for it. If he was paying for it, yes.
So that means that you disqualified him. Me. Yeah, but get it. This is what I'm saying. The point that I'm saying is you put him in a friend zone and disqualified him from sexual access with you because he couldn't pay for the hotel. So that means that you disqualified him. Let's peel the layer back. It's because he didn't have his financials in order. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Let's just say yes. That's all I'm saying. That was the point I was making. Fair enough. Thank you for
that's
being honest.
Problem.
That was
no Fugazee.
It makes sense.
Real sense.
Move right along. What's something you disqualify? Put a dude in friend zone for?
I think it's either off the bat, like lack of physical attraction, or maybe like where they're at in life, kind of like what they want relationship wise. Like if they're too young, or like not even it's like
too
an
young.
Age.
You like old
but
guys?
No.
What's the oldest you'll date?
Like 32.
32? Yeah. You wouldn't go up to 40? Like, say if it was a 40-year-old.
No.
But he was, like,
unless
in shape.
Unless it's, like, Aaron Taylor Johnson, then maybe.
Aaron Taylor Johnson. We don't know this individual.
But not Taylor.
But he sounds white.
Yeah.
He sounds white.
Yeah.
Okay. Got you.
Caucasian.
No, but I think, like...
From the Caucasus Mountains.
If they,
Viking.
Like,
is he a Viking?
I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah,
go.
I can't.
Like, if they... don't want something serious, or maybe that they let on that they do, but you can tell that they don't, they're not really trustworthy or something. But,
okay. So he's playing a card like, he's incongruent with his behavior. Mm-hmm. He's talking seriously, but he's not acting seriously.
Yeah, like they're
he's playing
inconsistent.
Games. Yeah, like he's just trying to like,
which is fine.
And,
it's like, you know, cause I'd rather just be friends with somebody like that. If like we get along on a platonic level and like, it's just like be upfront about
well,
that.
Well, it's platonic on your end,
unless
but not
they're
on
like
his.
Upfront, like, oh, let's hook up or whatever. But it's like, I don't like to. Yeah. But it's like, I'd respect it more if they were just like,
if they were honest,
I just want to hook up with you, whatever. But.
You respect it more, but you would still disqualify
him.
Right, but
I wouldn't
hook up, no.
So that means that you, the respect factor, you really don't respect it.
The honesty of like, oh, this is just what
you'd
I want out of this interaction.
Yeah. So like girls, I always say this, like girls want honesty to disqualify the guy.
No,
like,
I mean,
you
I think
say
you
that,
still, I think it's, you could still be friends with somebody like.
Yeah, but not friends if he has ulterior motives to clap them cheeks.
But I don't know from a guy's perspective, but like I feel like girls can kind of like move past that, like if it's not on both ends, like and but you get along, like you know what I mean?
True.
In a group setting, not that you're like going out.
In a group setting. So what I'm saying is, a friendship is a tango. It takes two to tango, right? Like you can't have a friendship by yourself. You know what I'm saying? Like you can't be friends with yourself. I mean, some weirdos do, but
I got
you really
a friend
can't.
In me.
I'm sure you got a friend in you, Woody, from Toy Story. it takes two to tango, or even in a group setting, you know, just as friends or whatever. So my point that I'm saying is the fact that he wanted to clap cheeks is the fact that it's not a genuine friendship, because that means that
That's
he has ulterior
off.
Motives.
Yeah.
So it wouldn't be platonic.
So
but for your end, you could view the guy as like, yeah, man, like, yeah, you're just friends. Like, I don't see you nothing more. Mm. But in the back of his mind, he's like trying everything. Like, okay, maybe if I say this here, or maybe if I invite her here, or maybe if I wear this nice shirt. He's trying everything to get in between them soul gaps, smack it and flip it around.
I think even if there's not like physical attraction off the bat, if like they're
for who?
If
not
they're
physical
funny,
attraction for who? For you?
For yeah, for the,
okay.
Like for me, that if they're funny enough, like if they have like a good sense of humor, I feel like they can kind of like it doesn't matter if they're like
you'll forget about
or something,
you.
Right?
Yes. You'll fall in love.
So you're saying that, and this is the part, right? So remember when I was giving game to the ladies. Women tend to prioritize the feelings part. So that's a guy being funny is just him being charismatic. You know what I mean? It's him conveying himself in a way where it makes you feel that vibe and you feel safe and secure and you giggly and fun around him.
Funny,
yeah, that's his... He's edging closer to getting in between them soul gaps and clapping. So, yeah, I mean, guys...
That's definitely that.
Keep rising up. Do what you gotta do out there in the streets.
She's hard to get.
Let's move it right along over this way.
Got so, pretty. Well, what... What is it about a guy that'll make you fence on him?
That'll make the friend zone.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, when you look at a guy and you be like, ah, nope, fence on him. Like, what is it? What is that factor? Physical attraction?
Everybody's different, so I can't speak for everybody.
All right.
Me, personally, you're going in the friend zone if you're immature. 35, acting like you're 20.
What else? There's got to be more.
Ain't cutting it.
Okay,
mentality.
No,
mentality.
It's not cutting. You gotta have a good mentality. You gotta know who you are, what you want, who you know what I'm saying, as a man, as a guy or whatever. You gotta know you.
God, so you got it. So you want a made man, you don't want a boy.
Exactly.
Pretty much so friendship is
long
story. What about you?
I agree with her. And also cockiness, you know, a man being very cocky. That's kind of a turn off.
What she was saying, like, if you boosting and boasting about your car,
yeah,
or if you boosting and boasting about your chain or something,
don't have
what
to
you
do all that to attract me.
I'm
a very down to earth person, yeah. And I'm very observant as well, and I give chances, but yeah, if you're always just, oh, I got stats and money like this, and I'm looking at your social media, you fanning your money,
the money phone.
Yeah, no.
We slide on his arm like this. And
yeah,
yeah, like
that is so whack.
You love doing that.
Like, what are you doing?
When does this stop? Like, are you gonna pay bills with that money? I mean, what are you doing? And you're doing that, and you don't have
your own house,
no priority,
no,
like,
responsibility,
no assets,
to show for. No assets, yeah. Right?
Walking liability.
Okay, fair enough.
Play that at that.
No. I'll let you know when you get one of those. You ain't get one of those yet.
I thought that was fire. I feel like you
like, hating, but whatever.
Play the no Fugazee sound. You funny. All right. You got anything you wanted to end on that? Because it was your question?
Nah, I'm good on that. That was good.
Okay. But, yeah. Let's get to the super chats. We got Skinny Boy, 20 Boy sends in $5. He says, celibacy is for virgins only. Abstinence for everybody else? Stop trying to co-op the movement.
I thought
feel that.
Talking about you, Shorty.
Whatever.
Just
refraining from.
We have Ninja Smokehouse sends in $2. Do the math. Let's play. Okay.
Who feel likes calculating?
Do the math. Let's play. Okay. We got Lupe sends in $2.
Fiasco.
Shout out to No Fugazi Podcast. No more ninja watching. Yo, yeah. No more ninja watching. Yo, everybody in here right now. We got a lot of people on live right now. Subscribe to the YouTube channel and click that notification bell so you're notified of the next podcast. Also, if you want to join and become a member, you can. We get all these special perks. It's in the chat. It's under Steven Jordan. The link is under there. Click on the link in the chat or even in the description, and you can join as a member. The first tier is gang, $5. Second tier is hitmen, $10. All perks is different. Then the third tier is mob ties. You pretty much family. You get access. Pretty much get my phone number, bro. You can call me whenever you want. We chop it up. We're going to be going to... we already took a trip to Vegas, but we're going to be going to Texas, Atlanta, and Miami soon. So, yeah, man, you're going to be up to date on all of that. And actually, the people that subscribe, mob ties, the merch, you're going to get that for free for sure. And a lot of other special things. But you get to see what perks you get. So even if you click on a link, you see the perks you get by tiers. So click it there because I don't remember it all. It's so much stuff. But yeah, we also got the Discord link in the description too. Sign up for the Discord. You get all the new updates and stuff when we go live. We go live Wednesdays and Fridays at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We got Young Zoe Poppy sends in $5. Ladies, most of y'all are sharing men. The question is, would you share an alpha man that treat you right in every way, or yes. a beta male that's only for you? Good question.
I just better not know, because I'm in the worst.
One mic at a time, ladies. One mic at a time. Let's do you first.
I just better not find out if I'm sharing, because I don't share. I feel like...
So it's one or the other. So let's make it concise so you can give a concise answer. Okay. So would you share an alpha man, right? Or would you share a beta male, but he's only going to be with you? It's monogamy, but with the alpha male, it's open on his end, closed on yours. Which one?
I'm gonna just be single.
Okay. Okay. You got to choose one. You sure you don't want to choose one?
Sure. No.
It could be some alpha males in the chat right now that want to, you know what I mean?
If I got to
make you unavailable, I want to make you unavailable.
If I got to devalue myself to be with somebody just because they take care of me, but they're hopping from this person to that person, possibly unprotected, could possibly bring me back.
Well, you moving it to the extreme. We're just talking about an alpha male, meaning that is open on his end. You know about it and stuff like that. He ain't going to be wilding out like that. But, you know, he may have another little piece from time to time.
And beta male.
Beta male gonna be celibate. I mean, beta male gonna be over with you.
But he don't do nothing.
Beta male gonna be monogamous. Okay, he don't do nothing. Hold on, but he a beta.
Hold on. Stop.
Meaning that you run the relationship. You wear the boxers.
Beta male doesn't mean he's broke and got no money.
Yeah.
Beta male, you know what I mean? Beta male, it just means that you gonna run all over him. He got money. He got everything, you know what I mean, to take care of you. But, like, he's just not a man. He doesn't stand on his... You don't stand by. We don't stand.
Yeah, it's very simple. With the beta male,
all over him, what you say goes.
With the beta male, you literally wear the boxers. With the alpha male, you get to sit back, chill. Life is good. You're a girl. You're a female. Life is good. You're a princess, pretty much. Beta male, no. You macho men.
I'm going to have to go with alpha. I can't.
Okay, she going with the alpha. Let's
move on
over here. Move it to you.
Alpha male.
Alpha male. She like, all right, I'm cool with me. I'll take the alpha. He can do what he want. And let's go with you.
I think I might have to go with the beta. Only because,
you're Gen Z, right?
Of course. I don't know.
Yeah. Just remember, beta male, it doesn't mean he's broke. It just means that he has money, all that other stuff. But the thing is, you run a relationship. What you say goes. You know what I'm saying?
So the question is, right? You got to think about it critically. Would you want to be in a relationship with the man, like long term, it's like forever, right? Would you want to be in a relationship with the man that you run things? That means one of your, correct me if I'm wrong, but one of the things that you want is security, right?
Mm-hmm.
The beta male can't give you that.
What do you mean by security? Like
the reason why security in every way, security mentally, security in every and all your aspects, so you feel good, ladies. One mic at a time, in every aspect, so you feel safe and secure, right? Security. The beta male can only give you financial security, but he can't. He can only give you financial security if he has it, but he can't give you the mental security. He can't ever. You'll never feel like a lady or a woman. You'll feel like a man. Because you'll be bossing him around.
Financial stuff aside, I feel like I just couldn't handle being with somebody that was sleeping with other people. So that's my
Okay,
thing.
So you're just going to, you're prioritizing that. So
that's
you'll
it,
be,
that would bother me too much.
Gotcha. So you'll rather be with the beta.
Even if they was broke, I wouldn't, I feel like I wouldn't, it wouldn't matter. Like, I just can't handle that.
Mm-hmm. That's
okay, fair enough. Yeah. And what about you?
Alpha.
She was quick with it. You want to elaborate on why?
I've been with that. I've been with poly relationships and everything. So okay. I'm with the, if the guy's...
doing his thing.
Yeah. And I'm still doing my thing because I'm independent, but...
Wait.
I'm not talking about sexually.
Flag on a play. You said you're not talking about sexually.
No, I'm talking about independent, meaning, I have my own money. I don't depend on him.
Okay, yeah. Because with the alpha male, it ain't open on your end.
Yeah, it's closed. On.
No, okay.
But not only that, with the alpha male, you talking about this independent stuff. No. With the alpha male, the alpha male doesn't tolerate a woman that's independent.
Okay.
He gets with a woman that depends, right? So you got to get out of that masculine frame and you got to submit. You still going to choose alpha?
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough. What about you?
I want an alpha mixed with beta. I don't care. Don't tell me, come on, because they exist.
You
gotta
be different.
They exist.
Why you gotta be difficult?
Because they exist.
You can't mix an alpha and a beta.
They
it's
do,
impossible.
They exist. I want an alpha it's man an that's understanding.
It's like, can you be fat and little at the same time?
You can, though.
Like,
you
fat, can be fat, fat and skinny. You can't be fat and skinny at the same time.
I swear to God,
time.
I know a person who's fat skinny.
But he got, but they got a fat top and a skinny legs?
Yeah. No, they just was
no,
fat.
No, they still fat.
They was just fat and they lost a lot of weight and now they're skinny.
No, 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 that was a change.
Skinny. They
that,
fat skinny.
No, no, they got like loose skin, you mean?
Yeah,
they
fat skinny.
Somebody who's big, but smaller than
listen, listen, listen.
But listen, I want both. I'm not going to, I don't care. I'm not choosing one or the other.
Alpha and a beta is a, it can't be mixed. It's an oxymoron. It's literally impossible.
What I'm saying is I want an alpha who's understanding and empathetic and caring. And
that ain't no beta. That's a human.
I said alpha.
Okay, you said
all
alpha.
Of that. Like I don't want no super controlling man. However, I do want him to have
put
control.
You in place.
Dominant. Yeah, but I don't want super dominant. Control. Like,
see, you always trying to take things to the far extreme.
I got to put it that way.
You don't have to put it that way. The man is gonna take care of you. Life is good, but he gonna clap cheeks on the side every now and then. You with that?
Oh yeah.
All right. Cool. That's all you wanted to know.
Yeah.
Okay. On to the chats, ladies. I got any questions?
I do.
Okay. What you got?
My question is there any man out there that just
I love that
just has a strong mindset with a little bit of respect, self-respect, and respect for their partner on the side? Like, I just want to know.
Wait, what?
Wait, that's kind of confusing.
Is it? Okay.
Ask that again.
You said respect
yeah,
for the
like
side hoe and what?
Respect for himself and then respect for his
with
person.
A man with discipline.
A discipline, yeah.
Yeah,
like,
because you're a friend zone.
That's not classified as beta or alpha because I feel like
they're gonna
it could
be classified.
Be an alpha male out here that is not stepping out, and I just feel like
it's
people
rare.
Just asking that question and just
and they do exist. It's just, they're just rare.
It's rare,
and it's like, what are the odds of
right, us? Right. Let's ask the question.
I just
want
to be single until he
ladies.
Does.
Ladies, let's have a conversation. Be concise.
Rare.
I got you.
Rare.
I got you, Mama. Hold up 1 second. So your question is, and we're gonna go around the panel with it. So you're gonna be next. So let's have a concise question so we can all go around with it. Say it again.
Okay.
Is there a man that is, go ahead.
Strong-minded and upholds self-discipline.
And holds up self-discipline.
Yeah.
Okay. That's your question.
Yeah.
Got you.
Without being classified as an alpha male that steps out or a beta male that just sit there and shut up the whole time.
Got you. So got you. So you're saying, is it a man that has his finances in order, he's a leader, he's a provider, he's a protector, and he only wants one woman, and he's a God-fearing man, and that, right?
Now, mind you, even if he doesn't have all of that together, he could be trying to work towards that. That's even...
Let me tell you something, Mama. Every man is trying to work towards something, but it's very few make it. Mm-hmm. So, that's that, right? The answer is, I guess we could answer this question. The answer is, yes, there are men like that.
Mm-hmm.
The other question is, do you qualify for a man like that? That's a real question, because then I would say, my question would be, are there any women that's modest, that don't post thirst traps online, that don't have an OnlyFans, that don't strip? A stripper just left the podcast. That don't sexualize themselves, that don't make themselves available at all, that is going to, that understands the order, God over man over woman over children, and that is going to follow a man's lead and submit to that man, cook, clean, and all that? Is there a woman like that, and that's going to be faithful?
Okay, I would say this, yes, and I'm not trying to boast myself, you know, because I know I said that.
You can speak in general. You don't got to speak about yourself.
The only, and I'm not even going to consider this a flaw, but some males have their preferences, and this could be a flaw for a particular male that I just spoke on that I would want. I have 2 kids out of wedlock. And outside of everything else you said, that's what I uphold as my own standards.
Yeah, so go ahead, Ease.
Yeah, so, I mean, what you got to understand is, like, every guy has a type, every woman has a type. Now, the guy that you want, you need to find out if you're the type of girl that he wants. For some guys, you having two kids is going to be a problem, especially if he wants his own kids. For other guys, they're not going to care. You know what I'm saying? So what I always tell women is, if you have kids and you want a guy to settle down with, your best bet is to date with guys who also have kids, because they're going to get it. They understand him. They usually don't want any more kids. Guys who don't have any kids usually don't want to deal with that, because you got to understand, what is the benefit for him? He's going to take care of two kids that don't belong to him, who's not going to give a damn about him when he dies. He's just going to throw him in a nursing home where he could just have his own kids that's going to give a damn about him when he dies or when he gets old, and they're going to take him in into their home.
And to make it even more clear, the guy that doesn't have any kids that would choose a girl that has two kids, well, he's beta. He's not even a guy. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? He's still a boy. Yeah, he's still got a lot to learn.
Also, meaning he doesn't have a lot of options. He struggles to get women, especially the women that he wants. So
if he doesn't have any kids and he's taking on a girl that has kids, that's like, he's a, probably no options, or a young boy, and he's not even a man. So it's like, you're how old? 30?
I'm 29.
20, yeah, 30. You dang near 30. Yeah. When your birthday?
December 19th.
Okay, yeah, you're dang near 30, about to come up. So, yeah. But the fact is this, right? So you asked a question. Now my question would be, do you qualify for that ideal man? Now, I would say that you don't qualify for the ideal man is because you got the two kids, right? So to find a guy like that, you're looking for a very rare guy.
Very rare.
Very rare.
Like Pretty was saying, rare.
Super rare. Because he still, like, even though you gave these metrics, he still needs to be cute. He needs to be your height preference. He needs to be charming. Like, what's your height preference?
I don't have those type of preference.
But he definitely needs to make money because she has two kids.
I don't have. Oh, yeah.
What's your height preference, though? Do you have a height preference?
No.
How tall are you?
I'm 5'2".
What was the last guy you was in a relationship? How tall was he?
It was like 5'9".
Okay. So, and then did you ever date a guy shorter than the last guy?
No.
Okay. So let's just say 5'9" is your minimum, right? Okay. So that's average. So that's doable. You could find that. Now let's go with, income. What's your income preference that the guy has to make?
Well, I would want him to make more than me, but how much? Like I said, like I have patience.
Okay, let's give a figure.
50K, 60K. How much money do you make 100K. A year? Do you know how much money you make a year?
How much I make a year?
A year, you're right.
37.
Okay, so you're making 37. So if he's making 50, that's good?
Yeah, that's good.
Okay, all right. So now you're getting somewhere. Your options is your options is growing a little bit. And guys, we're doing this without the calculator.
Yes.
So your options is growing a little bit more because the average population, the average income is about $45,000 a year. Mm-hmm. So that means that he just would be maybe a little bit above the average as far as income. So that's doable. The height is doable. Mm-hmm. You want him to be black?
Yeah.
Okay, got to be black. All right, well,
please.
A little harder to do. All right. I mean, you could find him. You could find him. Go to church.
We're talking about, but you're describing to me. You definitely could find.
I didn't know that was a jump reference.
Find a deacon.
You could find
him. Find a deacon to take you.
They ain't no good either.
Yo, they the worst.
It's like they don't
you
have
gotta check your friends on. First you can find
all,
a bunch of them.
In the Bible, it says a man finds a wife, he finds a good thing, not a woman. So I'm not going out there looking for nobody. Mm-hmm. And, you know, with that being said, I think we were more talking about the physical attraction, like the high. He got a little. I don't care about none of that stuff, honestly. Mm-hmm. And if a guy that I was entertaining didn't have kids or did have kids, I would not care as long as he took care of his kids. And if he didn't have kids, I don't put my responsibilities on any man while I'm dating them. Not married. I uphold my own responsibilities. I work. I have my own car, my own place. Everything that I need to do to take care of my own kids and to put my own responsibilities on myself.
Yeah, but the fact is when a man gets with a woman that has a kid, I know you may be self-sufficient and your life may be in order. But if it's a long-term situation, right, you will expect him to provide for those kids financially at some point. Is going to come to
baby father's not
at some point. So, but this is what I'm saying. So since it's at some point, Listen. Since it's at some point he has to provide for the kids, that's where you're going to lose a lot of options. So really, the kids, this whole, the type of guy you want, your standards aren't that high. You got very average standards, which is good.
Yeah, it's not bad.
That means that you can find a guy, but you got them two kids, so it's like, ah, that guy, he could have another option.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And I definitely ain't trying to go to church to get no deacon, because
I mean, you like, got to ask it for, get that deacon.
Like, I ain't doing none of that.
So you get a deacon, ain't no good.